Hello, welcome everybody. Thank you one more time for being here. We are so happy. This is a privilege for us to be able to be here with you sharing by this platform. Today, we're going to keep on enjoying with this worship time before we go to the topic that we have today. Thank you one more time. I hope you could enjoy as well in the same way that we are enjoying it. God bless you.
Wrongs.
Wow, thank you to the guys for this beautiful time of worship that we had. So in the last transmission, we were talking about the transformation. We were talking about how a life can be transformed by the presence of the Lord. And the last song, the song that we just finished to sing, is talking about that presence of God that is the only thing that we need to change. So in the last transmission, we were talking about this, a God who transforms lives. And today, we want to keep on talking about this because we believe that we could go even deeper in that. Because transformation, so we could have a transformation in the economy, in the world, in whatever we are doing. But the only thing that is going to really bring a real transformation is the presence of the Lord. But if you want to speak about this transformation, the first thing that we have to know is, what do we want to transform? So what is that thing that we want to transform? Maybe you want to transform the world. Maybe I want to transform my city. Maybe you want to transform the economy, the society, the humanity. Maybe you have you want to transform the thing of another people. But this is so important to know, what do I have to transform? What do you want to transform? This is the first question that we want to do today. The second question is, how are you going to change it? How are you going to transform that thing that I want to change? And the most important question is, why do I have to change or transform it? What is necessary to change or transform according with the Bible. What is God is thinking about transformation? What we need to transform? For that reason, we want to read in the Bible, in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. I'm going to read it. Verse 2, it said, "Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and prove what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will." So this is the base of the conversation of the topic that we are having today. And according with this verse, what do we have to transform? Does it say in the Bible that it's necessary to transform the world? Does it say that it's necessary to transform the economy, the lifestyles of others? No. It says, be transformed. So we have to change. So I have to be transformed. This is that we find if we search in this verse. But how are we going to change? How are we going to be transformed? In the same verse, it said, by the renewing of your mind. So what is the meaning of that? How are we going to renew my mind? According, this is so important, according with our thoughts, we gonna live. According of everything that we are thinking, we want to move, or our actions is going to be in that direction according with what we are thinking. So here, we have some of the answers that we are searching for today. So let's remember this question that we are making. The first, what do we have to transform? So what it need a change? We said the world, the economy, the society, the lifestyle of the people, the generosity. What do we have to transform? And we found the answer that we have to be transformed. So I have to be transformed. You have to be transformed. Why? We're going to see after that. The second question that we are bringing today is how I'm going to change? How I'm going to transform it? How? What do you need to transform it? What do you need to change that? And in this verse, I'm gonna read it again. This it said, Romans, I'm going to remember, Romans chapter 12, verse 11, it said, "Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will." And we have the third question, the answer of the third question, that is, why do I have to transform? So this is so clearly, if you want to know the will of God for you, for your life, you have to transform at first everything that you are thinking. So I have to transform every day, day by day. So it's not enough if I have been transforming 50% of my mind. So if I really want to know the purpose of the Lord, of my life, so if I really want to be transformed and I'm going to be able to transform my family, my job, my society, if I change everything in my mind with the principles and the values from God. So why do I have to transform? Because that is the only way that we are going to know the will of God. And His will is good, pleasing, and perfect. So if we transform our minds by the word of God, this is so important, we're going to be able to test and to approve what is the God's will. As we said, and this is so wonderful, this verse, because the will of God is not something heavy, it's not something difficult, it's not something that it's not enough, I know I'm not so good to be able to do that will. So this is good, it's a good will is pleasing and is comfortable and it's perfect. So that is the reason, because we need to transform ourselves. So in this verse, we have a lot of things to keep on searching, to keep on thinking about it. We have the question that we did, and we have the answer. Today, our topic is the will of God. Everything, everybody have to know about that will, that good will of God. But before going to this, in this topic that is so good, we're going to go even deeper. We're going to keep of having a worship time. We want to enjoy in the presence of the Lord, because we know in the Bible say that Jesus is moving in the middle of the worship. So I'm going to invite you to be comfortable, to take a seat, and feel free to worship God with the band.
Salvador, Rey de Reyes, Señor de Señor, no hay un Dios que existe mejor. Exaltado, glorificado, en la roca estoy yo parado. Y si el mundo se queda callado, las piedras gritan, alabado. Al vivo de lo que buscaba cuando tenía nada, mi alma estaba tan vacía de que wow. Con mi mano alzada, alabado, glorificado, que habré gritado cuando el diablo me tenía tan la gran casa, poderoso mi Dios, siempre Él vive, reina, hermano.
Con todo mi corazón, te amo, I love you.
éxito con Jesús a mi lado. Camino derecho, no camino de lado. Camino derecho con Jesús a mi lado.
Amen. Thank you for this. The music, the worship is so good. We really want to, we are thinking, we are enjoying this time of worship. So we're going to mix a little, like we're going to speak about, we are talking about that will of God. We are talking about transformation as in the last transmission, but today we are trying to go even deeper because we know that to be able to transform, we could go even deeper. So we were talking about this transformation and we were talking that we could go even deeper because the topic is so big. So transformation, in the same way that we were talking, we want to find that only in the presence of the Lord. In the same way that we were thinking, Jesus is in the middle of the worship. And today, talking about the will, we have bringing some questions, and we had three questions that we were making today. And the first question is, what do we want to transform? What do you have to transform? That is the first question. And we were thinking about that it's not necessary to transform everything in the world, the economy, the finances, no. In the Bible, we're going to read it again one more time later of this. It says that we have to be transformed. So what we want to transform, that is the first question, is my life had to be transformed. The second question is how I'm going to do to change it. We are talking that the only way to transform is by renewing our mind with the word of the Lord, by reading the Bible, by spending time with Jesus in prayer, and be able to speak with the Holy Spirit. And the third question that we are talking today is, why do I have to change or transform it? And this is the most important because we're going to read in Romans chapter 12. It said, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then, this is the answer of the question, I'm going to be able to test and to approve what God's will is. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Today, we are talking about this perfect will. Spending time with Jesus is the only way that we have to change. I could feel like I want to change, but only in my strength, I don't gonna be able to change anything. Or maybe I'm gonna change a part, but I don't gonna be able to change everything because I need the help from the Holy Spirit. I need God in my life day by day. So we wanna try to bring this verse in Romans. We want to speak about today. So how today in my daily life, how are we going to do to be transformed? In my job, in my family, in my society, in my neighborhood, what do you need to do to change that? For example, what do you do when you have some troubles? So it's okay when we are in the church, when we are here in family, we feel so good and it's easy to have good thoughts, to have my mind full of the presence of the Lord. But what's up when everything is not so good? What's happened when everything is not okay? What are the words that we are using? How are our actions with the people that is close to me? How is the way that I comporting with that people? But to have a really transformation, we have to be so focused in everything we think. We have to pay attention in if our life is reflecting the presence of God. And this is so good. And it's a really rhetoric answer. Do I am reflecting God? Maybe all the time I'm not doing it. So maybe, yes, I don't know. But this is a good question. Are we reflecting God enough? What we are thinking? What are our words? How are that words? We have to be so focused in everything that we are thinking in our daily life. So let's have a look in another important verse in the Bible. We're going to read now in Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about that. Sorry, one more time, a little up, please. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into a practice, and the God of peace will be with you. So in this chapter, we have the way, we have the solution. So whatever is good, whatever is praise, whatever is worthy, whatever is anything that is excellent, in that you have to think. So this is so good because God is giving us the way. God is talking today and it said, this is the way that you have to go. You have to walk with me day by day and think about it. As in the way that we are talking, God is giving us the way that we have to think. So this is so good because we are free. We have freedom in Jesus. And in that freedom, in that love, God is taking care of us. And it's in this chapter, in Philippians, he is giving us in everything that we have to think. For why? For why? For what reason? If we really want to know what is the will of God, we have to think in this. So I'm going to read it one more time. Finally, brothers and sisters. So this is for everybody. Brothers and sisters. Whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. So thank you, Lord, because this is the answer that we need. So I would like to remind the three questions that we were talking today. And the first is, if we want to really have a transformation in our society, the first thing is that we have to be transformed. So the first question is, what do we want to transform? And I'm going to say in my person, what do I want to transform? The second question is, how I'm going to transform this? what I have to do, what I have to leave or drop in my life to be able to transform my mind. And the third question is why? Why? Why do I have to change? So what's up if I don't feel like I want to change? So maybe you are thinking that, okay, it doesn't matter what you say because I don't want to change my lifestyle. And it's okay, so don't worry. So we have the free, but we have the Bible, and the Bible says, if you think about it, if you do it, if you transform your mind by the renewing of your thoughts, you're gonna be able to know, to test, and to approve the will of the Lord. So in the same way that we were talking in every transmission of La Gran Casa, we have the free. In front of us, we have two ways. So we have the question, we have the answer to take that decision. I want to change, I want to transform. That's gonna be my decision. Or maybe my decision is, I don't want to change, I don't want to be transformed, so I'm going to keep living in that way. And it's okay, we have the free will. And God is giving us today the way, because this is a promise. If you do it, the Lord say, you're gonna be able to know me, to know my will, and you're gonna know what is your real purpose. So why you are living, why you have the family, why you have the job that you have. So what is the reason? Because you are living in that country, in that city. So if you want to really know what is your purpose, if you want to really know what is the reason because you have that gift, that vocation, that profession, you first have to renew your mind. So the way that you're thinking is going to be reflected in the way that you move, in the way that you live. So today, I want to pray for you, for everybody that is watching us by this transmission. Before that, I want to tell you that we want to be in contact with you. So if you want to speak with us by the chat in YouTube, or maybe you want to write us by Facebook or Instagram, please feel free. Today, I want to pray, we as a church, as a foundation, we want to take a time for pray for you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, because you were talking to our hearts. Thank you, Jesus, because you are giving us the way to think, to have a successful life, to have a good life, and to be able to know your will. Thank you, Jesus, because in these two chapters in the Bible that we were reading in Romans and in Philippians, you are giving us the way, and you are with us. Today, Lord, we want to ask you, Jesus, if you want to be able to be in my heart. Today, I accept you in my heart, in my life, as my only Savior, and I say I'm sorry for everything in my life. Thank you, Jesus, because you are here in La Gran Casa, and you are there in every way by this transmission, by YouTube, by Facebook, by Instagram. In the Jesus name we pray. Amen. Well, thank you one more time for the worship band. This is so good to be able to sing. So the presence of the Lord is so amazing. here we are with the pastor, with Gustavo, and we are so glad because we know that by this platform we are raising a lot of places, a lot of country, and we are so happy for that. But before to keep talking, and the pastor Gustavo, they're gonna say something. We want to say that if you made that prayer with us, if you made that prayer accepting Jesus as your Savior, as your Lord, please let us know, because we want to be able to walk with you by this time. This is so good to be able to be in contact with people that think in, that have the principles of the value in Jesus. They are connected. So please let us know, be in contact with us. And as a church, as a foundation, La Gran Casa, you know, we are doing a lot of things. So we have a lot of activities during the week. And in the last week, in the last Saturday, yesterday, we were able to went to some underprivileged neighborhood to pass out some presents, some toys for the guys for the National Children's Day. So we are doing a lot of things, and we want to share with you everything that we are doing, because you could be part of us. So we have different ways to give. If you want to support us as a church, as a foundation, maybe you want to give, send an offering, or whatever you are thinking from God, please feel free, because we are a big family. The Pastor Gustavo, they're going to say something for us.
Muy buenas noches, Dios les bendiga.
Good evening, God bless you.
Es una alegría estar con ustedes hoy.
It's so good for me to be able to stay with you today.
También queremos agradecerle por estar ustedes también acompañándonos, y agradecemos que usted también están pasando los links de La Gran Casa.
We want to say thank you one more time, because we know that you are here with us by this platform, and you are sharing with your family, with your parents, the link of La Gran Casa. And this is so good. Thank you.
Muchas gracias también porque nos escriben, porque están con nosotros. Así que estamos muy agradecidos por su participación.
Thank you, because you are with us, because you are writing by WhatsApp, by YouTube, by Instagram, and we know that we are counting with you.
Estoy acá porque me gustaría esta noche compartir con ustedes un principio de nuestra casa.
Today I am here because I would like to share with you a principle, a value from this house, La Gran Casa.
Desde que comenzamos en este lugar, Dios nos inspiró.
From the very beginning, when we start with this job in the church, we have the inspirations from God.
Que Dios quiere bendecirte de una manera fuera de lo común.
And this is God want to bless you in a way, in an amazing way.
Y en los años hemos visto muchos milagros desatados en esta área, ¿no es cierto?, económica, y también en muchas áreas de nuestras vidas, de familias.
During all the years that we were working as a church, as a foundation, we have seen a lot of miracles of from God in our families, in the economy. We could see these miracles that is coming from God.
Así que nos gustaría que usted pueda probar a Dios para ver cómo Él le va a bendecir de una manera extraordinaria, sobrenatural, de aquí en adelante.
So today we want to encourage you to you be able to prove, to test, and to be able to touch that way, the generosity of God.
Estos principios realmente funcionan. Hemos visto en todos estos años en muchas personas de La Gran Casa.
And these principles and these values of generosity that we are talking, it really works. And we have seen during all the years this principle working in our families, in every person from our home.
La generosidad de esta casa hace que tengamos estos instrumentos, estos equipos, estas personas, como también como Javi, a Cami, a su esposa, que Dios les trajo a este lugar para transmitir la gracia de Jesucristo.
And we could see this the generosity of this family, of this house, as la gran casa, and we could see it in the giving of the people. And for that reason, we are able to share with you by this platform, by the instrument, by the music, and also with the people, everything of the musician, and also, as Gustavo, the pastor, say, as Javier and Hakamaya, and my wife, that is are reflected by the generosity of this family.
Así que creemos que usted también va a recibir milagros que usted está necesitando.
And we really believe that you gonna be able to receive that miracle that you are searching for.
Y siempre enseño que cuando usted da su ofrenda, dé dirección a su necesidad.
And everything that I have the opportunity to teach, I speak to the people that you have to give direction to the offering that you are giving to the Lord.
Me gustaría compartir un versículo.
I would like to share with you a verse from the Bible.
En 2 de Corintios, el capítulo 9, versículo 6.
In 2 Corinthians, chapter 9, verse 6. And it says, I'm going to read it. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously.
La escritura dice acá que si usted siembra escasamente,
and in the scriptures, in the Bible say, if you reap like in a few way,
también segará escasamente.
So in the same way, you're going to take that in the few way.
Pero el que siembra generosamente, generosamente también segará.
But that people, those who sows with generosity, they're going to reap with generosity.
Así que le desafiamos a ustedes que usted le puedan probar a Dios en esta área.
So today we want to really encourage you that you're going to be able to prove to test God in this area.
Así que siempre en esta casa, en todas las transmisiones, oro por aquellas personas que ya han dispuesto su ofrenda para Dios.
In every transmission that we are doing in La Gran Casa, as a channel in YouTube, we are praying for that people could receive that we are waiting from God.
Queremos que recuerde que Dios quiere bendecirle de una manera fuera de lo común.
So this is so important. We want that you remind, keep in your mind, that God wants to bless you in an amazing way.
Me gustaría orar por ustedes en este instante.
And I would like to pray for you in this moment.
Señor,
Lord,
quiero que bendigas.
I ask you may be able to bless
a estas personas,
to these people,
que ya han dispuesto en su corazón,
that in their heart they are putting something,
una ofrenda especial,
an special offering.
Sabemos,
we know,
que tú bendices,
that you are a God of bless,
al dador alegre,
the bless to that people that give with joy.
Y necesitamos,
and we need,
las ofrendas,
the offering,
para seguir extendiendo,
to be able to keep or raising
el reino de los cielos,
the kingdom from God.
Te damos muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Porque vas a bendecir,
because we know that you're going to bless
aquellos que dan de buena voluntad,
every people that is giving with joy, with good thinking,
con un corazón de fe,
with a faithful heart,
y alegría,
and joy.
Señor,
Lord,
mostrale,
show the people,
tu amor, tu gracia,
your love, your grace,
y tu bendición,
and your bless,
fuera de lo común,
your provision in an amazing way.
Nuestras ofrendas,
our offering,
honran a Dios,
that have to honor our God.
Amén y amén.
Amen, amen.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Por estar con nosotros.
Thank you because you are with us.
Y muchas gracias, Javi, por permitirme estar acá.
And thank you, Javi, for allowing me to be here. Thank you, Pastor, for allowing me to be here.
Thank you.
And thank you, everybody that is watching us by this platform. We want to repeat one more time. It's so good to be in contact. So we have different way to be in contact. As we said, we have the YouTube, the channel of YouTube. We have Instagram. We have the Facebook as La Gran Casa Official. So we have different way to be able in contact. Thank you one more time. Thank you because you're going to share the link. And now we're going to invite you to keep with us just a little time because we want to say goodbye with good music, worshiping God with this beautiful band that we have in La Gran Casa.
Señor, no hay un Dios que existe mejor. Exaltado, glorificado, en la roca estoy yo parado. Y si el mundo se queda callado, las piedras gritan, alabado. A ti no te lo buscaba cuando tenía nada. Mi alma estaba tan vacía y dije, wow. Con mi mano alzada, alabado, glorificado, que habré gastado cuando el diablo me tenía andado. Canta, hermano, con La Gran Casa, poderoso, mi Dios es fiel. Hoy, mañana, por siempre, Él vive, reina, hermano, amén. Con mi pisa a mi lado.